and getting mentally prepared to compete. You see the focus. You feel the energy. These guys are ready to go. Welcome, everyone, to a great Sunday night with the NBA here on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan. With me at the table, Greg Anthony and Richard Jefferson. And we've also got Hall of Famer David Aldridge reporting from the sideline. So the Nets starting five. We've got Johnson. Keefe is out there with Richardson. Then it's Bridges. And it's Claxton in at the five spot. And for Golden State, the core of this team all out there. Curry and Thompson in the backcourt with Green at the four. Shaquille O'Neal is out there with Andrew Wiggins.
For so long, the Golden State Warriors were waiting to be back at full strength. But when one guy comes back, it seems like another goes down. The injury bug has been a real challenge for them.
Go!
And so on. And here's Green. He'll bring it up for Golden State. Thompson inside the line. He drains the quick shot.
That's how you feel, bud.
Injuries, though, are an obstacle the Warriors, RJ, have met head on.
Yeah, it's impressive how
Curry looking it over. Thompson outside. Beyond the arc. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Thompson's got five.
And you can tell that Klay trusts his guys. He calls a play, and they just go to the right spots.
The last meeting of these two teams.
Damn, they want to
sharp defensively, disrupting the flow of their offense and causing a ton of turnover.
Oh, that's
that
a bug.
That was the key factor. And it has to have a carryover effect. You get in a team's hand.
Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far.
Come on, Jared.
First quarter.
Hey.
All right, Richard, we're right in the middle of the season, right in the thick of things. What is your main concern if you're a player playing at this particular portion of the schedule?
Your main concern is staying focused on the game of basketball. We understand everybody's been traded. I've been traded. You've been traded. I've been traded on the deadline before. So your goal is like, how do I just keep focused on basketball? That is the hardest thing. So that's always the trade deadline. You're not worried about anything else other than how do I keep playing my best. For a star like him, you get lots of opportunities at the line, and he's great at cashing them in.
For three, Bridges. One up, one down. And again, no good by Golden State. Brooklyn trails by six. To the middle.
Here's bang, bang.
On the wing, Bridges. Over Wiggins. It's blocked by Shaq.
And the aggressiveness on display here from O'Neal. Terrific.
Razzle dazzle for the
hand, huh? With that size and length.
The Warriors lead. Curry kicks to Shaq. The pass to Green. Outside Curry.
Oh, no.
He shot the triple. He'll go to the line for three free throws.
Well, we might as well count those free throw shots. Curry is automatic at the line.
And he's good on the first of three. You know, Richard, had to be extra special for Steph Curry to set the three-point record in New York.
Yeah, doing it in the Mecca, sold-out arena. The previous two record holders there, December 15th, 2021, a great day in the career of Steph Curry, the history of the NBA.
Cauley Stein, he's checked in for Nicholas Claxton. And the second free throw, good.
And one of the many special things about Steph Curry, his loyalty, sticking with this Warriors franchise since being drafted back in 09.
Last one's. It's Redick on the wing. He's covered by Thompson.
The insane peripheral vision there. If anyone's open, even for an instant, Magic's gonna find you.
Golden State's gone 1-5 from downtown the first quarter. Points out there have been hard to come by. Here's Curry with the three.
What a shot.
In his first bucket of the game. He's 1-for-2.
And the greatest shooter you've ever seen. Curry is just lethal from outside.
Cauley Stein with the screen for Johnson. And it's O'Neal's got four rebounds now tonight. Curry dishes to Thompson. drills the three-pointer. Thompson's got the first points up.
Gotta love the advancement. Really, the evolution of the three-point shot in today's game.
Well, you look at Prez. He's all the way up there at number two in the voting for the three-point contest. Fans and the media know they've gone one or two on three-pointers here in the second quarter. So inside, and he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a three-point play chance here for him.
Looking unstoppable. Even the foul can't hold back Curry's shot. In the league for 13 seasons. You know what that's called? Good genetics.
And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. Of course, the Warriors offense stands out for its emphasis on ball movement. Coach Steve
Kerr says,
you get to touch the ball and be a part of the action. Whether it's as an assist man, ball mover, shooter, dribbler, the more people who are involved in the offense, the more powerful it becomes. Kevin, strength in numbers, indeed.
Waited way too long. Curry with it, and it's Johnson picking him up. Curry against Johnson.
No, Magic.
And that's good. Stephen Curry for three. Curry's got the lead up to nine now. Curry on the wing. Launches it. It's hauled in by Claxton.
Bang, bang.
Claxton's I'm calling got six it. Rebounds now in the game.
And just a step ahead of the D in that possession there, making the pass.
And here is Curry, 11 points in the game. Out to Thompson, lets it go from deep. And a great assist by Curry, and that one goes in.
Bro,
now
Prez
is coming off an unbelievable scoring game.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope, he is only concerned right now is getting the points on the board. And I don't mean style points. Warriors leading by eight. Curry dishes to O'Neal. Pass to Wiggins.
Look at Curry.
Here's Curry with the three. Another three for Golden State.
Defensively, they just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
The way Greg, they're sharing the ball tonight, mesmerizing.
Everyone's getting to touch it, and then everyone contributing. Okay. The taking matters into his own hand.
Yeah, we didn't expect to see that kind of finish.
A point guard getting up like that? Boy, that is special.
Now, here's Wiggins. He's coming off a 10-point game against Cleveland.
And how about the vision he displayed? Great job getting
same spot.
And piling up the assists.
And here we go.
Keith with a screen on Kirk. Johnson, the pass to call his
shot.
A tremendous athlete and a dynamic.
Beal's got a sixth rebound on the night.
Okay, now I think he's starting to get in his own head right now. Maybe he's overthinking things a little bit, and as a result, he's just been off.
With that height and incredible leaping ability.
The hole is wide open. Nobody was
to Keith.
I'm pulling
from
that.
Deep three-point range, an absolute bomb. They've been putting on a clinic in the paint. Shots are falling with regularity, and they are pounding it down low. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Steve, a good rhythm for you in the first half. What do you like most about how your team's competing?
Just like the ball movement, you know, the drive and kick. Our guys have played really well together. Just trying to move the ball, get a great shot.
We'll see if we can keep the ball flying around as we continue. Thanks. Back to you guys.
And we turn our attention back to tonight's game. Stephen Curry. He makes it look
effortless.
Worked up a nice lather in the first half.
I love his aggressiveness, getting buckets on buckets. He's putting his stamp on this game.
And credit his teammates for consistently putting the ball in his hands.
I like how they came into this one with a game plan, and they're just going out and executing it.
That
terrific job.
Shutting the floor.
That man jumping.
He's out there with Richardson. Then it's Johnson. Then it's Bridges. And it's Claxton in at the pivot spot. Manning's
feelings in sport. And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay.
And he lobs it up toward the rim.
Oh my God.
Kicks it out to Richardson.
Too much
Bridges against Thompson.
Let's go.
And there's Prez on the assist by Bridges. Bridges has got his third assist on the night. Thompson with it. He's got 13. Outside Curry.
How did he get?
And they come right back with the own 3 points.
Right.
Curry's got 22.
The offensive success is due in part to his quality shooting.
Let's go, man.
That should give him a nice little jolt.
Yeah, it has to. They need
bang on Shaq too. Let's go.
More wear.
Into the third we go. 2 minutes in now. Warriors leading by 15. This is a Joel Neal. It's stolen by Prince. Pass to Claxton. And you know that's going to be goaltending, guys.
I kind of fucked that up myself. Man, yeah.
Just over 2.5 minutes gone by.
Bang, bang.
And I will say, sort of surprising.
Here's Keith. No good there, and that would have cut it to single digits.
And about Mikal Bridges, just how good can he be?
He's got the power to be off the dribble inside. Certainly likes to attack the paint, but he can also spot up or beat you from beyond the arc.
And here is Prez. 14 points for him. From deep.
Oh my God, he just
pulled
up on him.
Stephen Curry for three.
This is
Curry's
got
over. Here in the quarter. And a breakdown here, guys. The Hustle stats for the Warriors. Now a timeout call by Brooklyn.
That is nothing.
No good on the second free throw. Greg Ben Simmons, one of four players in the entire history of the NBA to average at least 7 rebounds and 7 assists per game during his first 4 seasons.
Think about it, Jordy. Magic Johnson, Oscar Robinson, and Luka Doncic. That is some pretty elite level company.
Here's Johnson following the basket by Shaquille O'Neal. Thompson with it. Now guarded by Simmons. It's sent back down by Simmons.
An excellent defender. Whether Simmons is in.
Stackhouse dishes to Green. Passes to O'Neal.
There's nothing we can do with the Warriors.
Good.
There's nothing we can do with the Warriors.
Shaq's got 8 points here in this quarter.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good looks.
Here's Johnson. Here's Keith. Ooh. Nice concentration to hit the double clutch layup. Keith's got 16.
And he's doing everything he can offensively to lift them out of this hole.
They're on an 11-3 run right now. Here's Stackhouse. Defended by Bridges. Curry. Johnson with the clock. Pass to Keith.
I should have pulled that shit.
Trying to find Shaq. He's got it now.
That should have been horrible.
Here's Stackhouse. Another three for Golden State. Johnson's got 6 assists in the game. And for the Warriors, they're shooting 52% from the floor. Nice work so far from them. We've got Shaquille O'Neal.
Bro, who's this man up the court?
Then on Thursday,
that was the most,
and they'll be hosting the Detroit Pistons.
And you know for that matchup with New York. That's going to be one where it would take a lot of errors and maybe a cold shooting night for things to go wrong. They just have that much of an advantage.
State's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth.
Like, how did he get that pass all the way?
And they'll get another chance. Ananobi kicks to Thompson. O'Neal inside. The end of the route. Second chance shot. Persistence pays off as they finally hit a shot. Shaq's got
balling.
4 points
they
this
quarter.
So it's Johnson who brings the ball on. Pass to Keith. On D. That's in. Coming off the assist from Johnson.
3 points.
Johnson's got 10 assists here tonight. So active. Curry against Johnson. Curry kicks to Thompson. And another three for Golden State.
After a tremendous first quarter, 3 trays, he's put in another.
Curry against Johnson. passes it to Bridges. And player nicknames are a fun part of covering the game. Now a lot of guys are just going with their initials, like KD or AD or KG. Do we need more creativity?
I don't know, Kevin. Maybe the league could give guys a cash bonus for picking a nickname. But initials excluded.
Man, what the fuck?
Now here's Curry. Thompson is double. The three.
We're letting OG on Nova. Whatever his damn name is.
Johnson inside.
Everybody is Curry meets him.
Back to Johnson.
What the hell is going on, Magic?
Perez with the ball. In the corner, it's Richardson.
I'm a drop shot.
The Nets need to get a shot off here. Boy, he
left
that one from way outside. Thompson outside. On the pass to Curry. Puts up a three. That's in.
This coming off
the
assist from
Thompson. Thompson's got six assists now in the game.
What a response from Curry. Gotta know he's coming for his revenge.
This is over.
Curry against Johnson. To the paint.
Deflects the pass. What are you saying? What the hell going on?
Outside Green. And it's Curry at the elbow. Launches a three. Hands it from downtown. Curry's got 9 points now in the quarter.
He's found his rhythm from deep, and you can see the confidence.
And of course, it helps space the floor, which gives this offense more room to operate.
Perez kicks to Johnson. Perez from deep three-point land. The long distance three is buried. Keefe's got 29 in the game.
And he's clearly led the way offensively. The question is, can they ride him and get back into it?
Richardson against Anunoby.
Don't let him. Nah, it's too late.
One of the biggest changes in the NBA since I start broadcasting back in the
early 80s.
Oh,
my God.
Your movement, but your guys switching teams all the time. Is that a good thing or a bad thing for the NBA?
Oh, my God.
I think for the players, it's great. For the fans, I understand. Probably not so much because, really, they connect to these players, especially when you draft them or they're part of an epic year or a championship. You just hate to see those players go. So there's two sides to it.
And I bet as a player, knowing you as I do, you probably enjoy the challenge of trying to reassert yourself, find out where you could best help your new team.
Yes, and you enjoy your new role. I've been in roles where I was expected to be a Thompson, Steph Curry, Draymond Green, Harrison Barnes. All those guys were drafted in my time in Golden State.
Curry passes to Thompson. Here's Green, guarded by Keith. And there's the feed to Curry. Good, and it's Green picking up the assist.
Did that bitch
Green's
just shimmy on us? Oh, yeah,
so. Green is taking the game here.
It's
over. Showing in front of the crowd. That
motherfucker.
And, you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home, no doubt helps. And the execution was flawless.
A chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Draymond. When you look at the stat sheet and why things work tonight, what are you looking at the most?
Turnovers. That's the key to the game. Look at turnovers and how many free throws they shot. If they weren't able to set their defense, we didn't turn the ball over, we were able to set ours. Those are the two things I look at.
Certainly sounds like the foundation to victory, man. Congrats again. Back to you.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that'll do it, folks. This is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And now, we present the New Balance Player of the Game, Shaq.
Wait, hold up. I'm finna turn this bitch up. Ride through the city where it's litty, counting hundreds, counting 50s.